The Bible says one Lord.
One faith.
The Bible says one body of teaching that leads one or puts one into the body of Christ. One faith, yes.
One baptism.
Now, you've been told, and when you've been told it, you've been lied to. You've been told that some people say, well, you have to be baptized with the Holy Spirit. Well, how many baptisms did Paul talk about?
One baptism.
Now, the apostle says one baptism. That one baptism is the baptism that saves man. Now, one of the arguments against baptism is, what about the thief on the cross? Let's go to Hebrews chapter 9. Hebrews chapter 9. And people will say, well, the thief on the cross wasn't baptized. Well, how do you know that? Have you read in the Bible where the thief on the cross wasn't baptized? I mean, here's the point. The thief on the cross lived under another covenant. That's the point. Before any apostle was told to go and preach the gospel to every creature, that's when the thief was spoken to by Jesus. Now, when you don't rightly divide the word of truth, you come up with these so-called analogies trying to curtail what the Bible says about baptism. Now watch Hebrews chapter 9, verse number 16.
Hebrews chapter 9 at verse 16. Mm-hmm. For where a testament is.
Now, while Jesus was on earth, he could carry out his will any way he wanted to, because the agreement or the testament wasn't in force yet, the New Testament. The Bible says what? Hebrews chapter 9, verse number 16.
For where a testament is.
Now, notice what this says. For where a testament is,
there must also of necessity.
Now, where there's a testament, it's necessary that there be what?
There must also of a necessity be the death.
Now, wait a minute. When Jesus was communicating with the thief, he was alive.
Amen.
That's right.
Wasn't he?
That's right.
Now, the prophet spoke of the new covenant coming. Jesus spoke of his blood being poured out for the new covenant. But while he was on earth, Jesus could walk around and just say, your sins are forgiven. Jesus could walk around and just say, your faith has made you whole.
Amen.
But once the covenant was ratified, now you got to go by the executor's rules. See, but while he was on earth, he could do whatever he would. Just like, take for example, a person that has a will, they're getting a will written. As long as they're living, they can say, here, Brother Bill, here's my record collection. Here, Brother Arnold, here goes some sweaters I don't want. But once that person dies, whatever's in print, that's how the property or clothing or cars is distributed. Same thing with the gospel. Once Christ died, buried, and rose again, went back to heaven, now the apostles were responsible for preaching the gospel of Christ. And here's a question for you. If you believe you can be saved like the thief on the cross, then of necessity you believe you're saved without the gospel.
Okay.
Well, why? The thief on the cross wasn't living when the death, burial, and resurrection of Christ was being preached. So you couldn't even answer that. You didn't say, well, thief, what about the gospel? He don't know nothing about it. Didn't know nothing about the gospel. So he says, Hebrews chapter 9, verse number 16 says what?
For a testament is, there must also of necessity be the death of the testator.
Yeah, so where it is, the testator has to die.
Amen.
You see that? Keep reading.
For a testament is of force.
Now watch this. When is a testament a force?
For a testament is a force after.
Wait. A testament is a force when?
After.
A testament is a force when?
After.
Now, was it Jesus and the thief alive when the thief said, "Remember me"? Now, what person out there has access to say to Jesus, "Remember me when you come in your kingdom"? The kingdom's already here, so you saying that would be too late. Second of all, those of you who want to hold on to the position of, well, the thief on the cross wasn't baptized, let me ask you this. Since Jesus was on the cross in the middle, why did you take your eye off of Jesus and now you want to be saved like a thief? You see what I'm saying? You say, many people will say, "I want to be saved by Jesus. I want to be saved by Jesus. Jesus saved. Jesus alone." Well, how did you get over to the thief? Keep reading.
For a testament is a force.
For a testament is a force.
After men are dead.
After men are dead. Jesus told the apostles after his death, burial, and resurrection, he told those men, "Go preach the gospel." That's the age, that's the covenant that we live under today. So there's no need of nobody going back trying to get the thief. No need of nobody looking at the thief. What you need to do is obey Jesus. Keep reading that now.
For a testament is a force after men are dead.
Now what's the point here?
Otherwise.
See, now here's the point. Here's the point right here. Otherwise what?
It is of no strength.
It is of no strength.
At all. While the testator liveth.
See, while he's living. So what's the point? The point is, nobody was told to go preach the gospel because Jesus hadn't even died yet, man. How could you preach something that hadn't even happened? You see what I'm saying? Now, let's go to Acts chapter 2, verse number 40. Here's another argument. False prophet will say, baptism has nothing to do with salvation. Baptism, as the false prophet has said, now notice this, they'll say baptism is important but not necessary, right, brother? That's what they'll say. Yet if you say, "Is belief important?" they'll say belief is important, belief is necessary. Amen. If you say, "Is repentance important?" they'll say repentance is important, repentance is necessary. Is confession of Christ important? Confession of Christ is important. Confession of Christ necessary. But soon as you say baptism, then they say, "Well, baptism is..."